It looks like an Airbus A320. It flies like an A320. But is the COMAC C919 just a Chinese clone? Or is it a real competitor ready to challenge the giants of aviation? Let's break it down in detail. The Airbus A320, Europe's revolutionary narrowbody jet, changed the way we fly since 1988. With over 10,000 aircraft delivered, it dominates global skies. Now, meet China's answer to that success, the COMAC C919, built by the Commercial Aircraft Corporation of China and aiming to break the Boeing-Airbus duopoly. At first glance, they seem nearly identical. The fuselage width? Almost the same. Nose profile? Very similar. Wing design? Again, strikingly close. But look deeper. The C919 is actually slightly longer and wider, with a modernized wing structure designed for improved aerodynamics. It can seat up to 168 passengers, compared to 140 to 170 on the A320, depending on layout. Both aircraft use CFM LEAP engines, the latest generation of high-bypass turbofans. But here's the key difference. The A320neo uses the LEAP-1A. The C919 uses the LEAP-1C, similar core, but with a Chinese-developed nacelle and thrust reverser system. Performance-wise, both jets offer comparable range, around 4,000 to 5,000 kilometers. But Airbus has decades of real-world data. The C919 is still a newcomer. Here's where Airbus set the standard. The A320 was the first airliner to feature full fly-by-wire and side-stick controls. The C919 also uses fly-by-wire and side-sticks, but with modern avionics largely sourced from Western firms, Honeywell, GE, Rockwell Collins. In fact, around 60% of the C919 systems are still foreign-made, for now. The A320's global supply chain spans Europe, North America, and Asia. Its newer variants use more composite materials for weight reduction. The C919 is mostly aluminum alloy. COMAC claims that over 70% of the airframe is domestically produced, but key tech, like landing gear and electronics, still come from abroad. The A320 is certified globally by the FAA, SA, and flown by over 350 airlines. The C919 received type certification from China's CAAC in 2022. It entered service with China Eastern Airlines in May 2023. But as of now, it's not yet approved for operation in Europe or the US. Airbus has delivered over 10,000 A320s across 100-plus countries. The C919, meanwhile, has over 1,200 orders, mostly from Chinese airlines and leasing companies. COMAC is targeting domestic dominance first, then global sales. But international airlines may wait years, or even decades, before trusting a brand new aircraft without proven reliability. Is the COMAC C919 just a copy? The resemblance is clear, in shape, systems, and supplier partners. But it's more than that. It represents China's ambition to build an independent aviation future. A stepping stone, not a finish line. Airbus and Boeing didn't get here overnight. COMAC is only just beginning. Will the COMAC C919 replace the A320? Not today. Maybe not tomorrow. But it's already reshaping the global aviation game. Would you fly the C919? Drop your thoughts in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for more real aviation stories, right here on our channel.